Hello students, so in the previous video we had discussed about motion under the gravity, right? And we had also discussed about the sign conventions in solving the questions based on motion under gravity, right? In today's video we'll first solve the basic questions of motion under gravity, and then in the next video we'll solve the questions with a higher level. Okay, see, the rules were displacement, velocity in upward direction will be taken positive, right? Displacement, velocity in downward direction will be taken negative. This will be taken positive. Yes, acceleration due to gravity will always be taken negative, right? And if the object is thrown from this point and if it reaches here on the ground, then consider the final position. These are the rules which we had already discussed in the last video, right? See, if the final position is below the initial position, then the displacement will be negative, right? And if final position is above the initial position, take the displacement as positive. Clear? Clear? Okay, see. Let us start solving some basic questions related to gravity. Let us say a ball is thrown upwards with say any initial velocity V0, right? You are throwing a ball in upward direction with any initial velocity V0. Okay, find time taken to reach maximum height. Also find the maximum height. Also find the maximum height. So this is your question, right? You are throwing a ball with any initial velocity V0. You have been told to calculate the time taken to reach maximum height and also the maximum height. That means, let us say this ground, I am throwing a ball in upward direction with any velocity V0, right? So it is clear that the ball is moving against the gravity, right? But it is moving with an initial velocity V0. Now, time taken to reach maximum height, suppose the ball goes up to this height. So see, one thing is sure, at maximum height, what will be the velocity? Zero. Velocity of the object, if you are throwing something in upward direction, it goes up to this height. So at this height or at this point, the velocity becomes zero, right? So the point where velocity becomes zero, that is known as, that distance is known as maximum height. Okay. So we can use this equation V0 plus 80. We'll apply sign convention. Okay, fine. We need to V equals to V0 minus GT. V and V0 will be positive because V0 is in upward direction. V is 0. So 0 equals to V0 minus GT. So T equals to, so this will be the maximum time or time taken to reach maximum height. Now you have been also told to calculate the maximum height. Okay. So again, we can use the equation of motion where final velocity is 0. That means I can use the third equation, V square minus V0 square equals to 2gh. Let h be the maximum height, h. See, for h to be maximum, final velocity will be 0 because at maximum height, the velocity will be 0. So 0 minus V0 square equals to 2 minus g. H maximum. So minus V0 square minus 2G. So maximum height will be V0 square by 2G. Clear? Clear? Right? So this is how we will calculate the maximum time, maximum height. Done? Fine. Okay. Another one. An object is allowed to fall freely. Find the ratio of displacements. That means ratio of the height covered from 0 to 1, 0 to 2, 0 to 3 seconds. Okay. See, one thing is clear, object is allowed to fall freely. So initial velocity is 0. right? Okay, we have been told to calculate the ratio of the height covered from 0 to 1. So t equals to 0, initial velocity is 0 because it is performing free fall. 1 second, this is the height covered, h1. Okay, 0 to 2, let us say here 2 second, this is h2, right? And 3 second, say somewhere here. You have been told to calculate the ratio of h1 is to h2 is to h3. Okay, fine. We can use this equation. Displacement is v0t plus half at square, right? See, object is coming in downward direction. So h1 will be negative, v0 is 0. This will be minus half g1 square. H1 is equals to g by 2. Say this as equation 1. Right, in the same way, substitute t equals to 2, so h2 will be minus h2 will be minus half g 2 square, so h2 will be g by 2 into 4, right? And in the same manner, minus h3 equals to minus half g 3 square, so h3 will be g by 2 into 9. Got it, right? This is g by 2, this is 4 g by 2, this is 9 g by 2. So the ratio of h1 is to h2 is to h3 will be 1, 4, 9. Got it? Clear? So see, this is 1 meter, this is 4, and this is 9. Now if in the same question they have been told to calculate the ratio from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. Right, see, we have calculated the ratio from 0 to 1, 0 to 2 and 0 to 3. If in the question the ratio of 0 to 1, ratio of height from 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3. So then ratio will be, this is 1, this is 4, so this will be 3. This is 9, this is 4, so this will be 5. So your answer will be 1 is to 3 is to 5. Clear? Clear? We'll solve another question. Okay, the next one. An object is thrown upwards with velocity v0. It can go up to a maximum height of 16 meter. That means if you are throwing an object, it can go up to a maximum height of 16 meter. Find the height where its velocity becomes half. See, one thing is clear, whenever you are throwing an object in upward direction against the gravity, as the object moves in upward direction, its velocity keeps on decreasing, right? So in the question, they have said that you are throwing an object with a velocity v0, it can go up to a maximum height of 16, right? This is the maximum height, 16. So at maximum height, we had already seen what will be the velocity, 0. Right, so see, you are throwing an object with velocity v0. As the object moves in upward direction, velocity keeps on decreasing. So to calculate the height where its velocity becomes half of initial, that is v0 by 2. Let us say somewhere here, right? So we need to calculate this. Okay, fine. And here, what will be the velocity? v0 by 2. Okay. Fine. First, okay, at maximum height, what will be the velocity? 0. So we can use this equation, v square minus v0 square equals to 2gh, right? At maximum height, which is given 16, the final velocity is 0 minus initial, okay, it's not given, it's minus v0 square, 2, g is always taken negative into 16, So V0 square by 2G will be equals to 16. Of course, you can find V0 from this equation, and then again you can substitute. Okay, now let us make the equation between these two, this and this. So I am throwing the object with velocity V0. So this will be my initial velocity and this will be my final velocity. So again the same equation, but now my final velocity is V0 by 2 the whole square minus V0 square equals to 2G H dash. G will be taken negative, of course. So this will be V0 square by 4 minus V0 square equals to 2 minus G H dash. So this will be minus 3 by 4 V0 square equals to minus 2 G H dash. Right, so this will be 3 by 4 V0 square by 2 G equals to H dash. But what is V0 square by 2 G? 16. So this will be 3 by 4 into 16 equals to H dash. H dash will be 12 meter. So at a height of 12 meter from the ground, right, the velocity of the object becomes half of the initial. Clear? Clear? These were all the basic sums of gravity. Right. Now let us solve one more question, one more derivation. Now we'll do one derivation and then we'll take a bit high level sums, but in the next video. Okay, see. Suppose this ground. Let us say this height h. This is height h. A person is throwing a stone or any object with velocity v1. At the same time, another person is allowing an object to perform free fall. Right? Is allowing object to perform free fall. So this is performing free fall. So its initial velocity is 0. Right? Find the time when they will be meeting or when they will be crossing each other. Yes, you are understanding the situation. I am throwing an object with a velocity v1 in upward direction. At the same instant of time, another person is allowing another object to perform a free fall. So this object will be coming in downward direction, this will be moving in upward direction. So we have to calculate the time when they will cross each other. Right? Okay. See, let us say this object comes here, this comes here. Suppose they are meeting here. So this is, let us take this as H1 or take this as H2, take this as H1, no problem. You can take any H1, any H2. Okay. So first we will make the equation of H1. Let us say both the objects meet at a time t. So for this first object H1, it is in upward direction, so displacement will be positive V1 t minus half g t square. V1 is also in upward direction. So it will be positive, g is taken negative. Okay, and for this object, since it is performing free fall, so velocity will be 0. So it is coming in downward direction, so minus h2 equals to minus half g t square. V is 0 because it is allowed to fall free. So h2 is equals to half g t square. So finally h1 equals to v1 t minus, instead of half g t square I can write it as h2. H2 will come here, H1 plus H2 equals to V1T. Therefore, time T will be, but what is H1 plus H2? H. So, H upon V1. Clear? Clear? If now I am making a minor changes in this equation, that is now I am saying that I am throwing another object with velocity V2. That means the second object is not allowed to perform free fall. Second object is not performing free fall now. But I am saying that the second object is falling with velocity v2. That means first object is thrown up with velocity v1. At the same time, another object is thrown down with velocity v2. Then what will be the time? Clear? Let us solve that. So in this case, this object is coming down with velocity v2. It is not performing free fall, and this object is moving up. Okay, so then h1 will be equals to v1t minus half gt square. This will have the same equation, right? Okay, this is in downward direction, so it will be minus h2, right? Now v2 is also in downward direction, so minus v2t, g is always taken negative. Okay, so I can take common, I can take minus sign common from left and right hand side. So this equation will be h2 equals to v2t plus half gt square. These are your two equations, h1, h2. Now we know that h1 plus h2 is equals to h. So let us add this equation. Say this has 1, say this has 2. On adding 1 and 2, this will be h1 plus h2 equals to, this gets cancelled, v1t plus v2t. So it will be v1 plus v2t. So t is equals to, but what is h1 plus h2? H upon v1 plus v2. Clear? There are more cases that what if they are meeting above, what if they are meeting below. We had discussed one case that they are meeting here, right? We'll discuss one more case. What will be the time taken if both the objects are meeting over here? That means if I am throwing this object in upward direction, so it will go this way. Suppose if it reaches here, the another object reaches here, so now they are meeting at a height above, then at a height below. So those are the cases which we need to discuss. So now in the next video, these were all the basic questions, basic rules which I have explained, and accordingly I have solved the questions. In the next video, we will solve these conditions first, we will understand it, and then we will solve the questions but of higher level.